That overtime game winner is something Alex Wennberg will never forget. Can you break it down for us and what went wrong for the Panthers?
Yeah, well, typically off of faceoffs, everyone's got their responsibilities, center on center, wing on wing. And if we take a look at the way they're set up, typically what happens is the centerman is responsible for the set. Well, Hank, just stop it right here, guys, right off the bat. So the centerman is supposed to stay with the centerman off the draw. The other thing that's supposed to happen is that the winger, this winger is going to go out to his defenseman. The other winger is going to go out to his defenseman. Stay with me. Hang on one more second. There's one other assignment here. Defenseman stays with the winger, and this defenseman is supposed to stay with the other winger. Now we can run it. And as we run this, go ahead, guys. Wingers are trying to get through. Defenseman's with defenseman. And if we stop it right here, all of a sudden, here's the centerman. He's lost his centerman. That's when Wennberg coming to the side. Now, Oliver Ekman-Larsson came over to the side because his winger is over on this side, over here. So that's part of the reason he vacated. And as we run it, all of a sudden Rodriguez totally forgets and stop it. Yeah, you got a guy who is wide open. And as Bruce pointed out, not only did he tip the puck, had he gotten a rebound, he would have been wide open for two or three more chances. So we run it, the tip, he's wide alone, wide open, all alone in front. That's a breakdown by Rodriguez. I think I said Barkov originally, but that's Evan Rodriguez, who took a lot of draws tonight, but typically Sam Bennett takes draws. Mm-hmm. Sam Bennett, we think, maybe has a hand injury, a wrist injury, so he wasn't in the faceoff dot. There's no way Wennberg should be that wide open. I think Evan Rodriguez has to stay with him. Coach, what did you see on the play?
Exactly what you just described. I mean, there's ways you play every faceoff. And like a lot of times, if the centerman comes up, then the centerman will release him and get out there and play three above. So the centerman's out there. But in this case, OEL should have stayed in front of the net. Okay, mm-hmm. And Rodriguez should have stayed with the centerman because there was only two defensemen up there. All the forwards were still stuck in there. So
right.
I mean, he let him go, and once you let him go, then it's, and he's trying to block the shots. But again, like you just said, he took a lot of faceoffs and he played a lot of right wing. But I mean, Bennett was out earlier in the playoffs, I think, with a hand injury. If you remember, mm-hmm. He got hit in the hand. So maybe that's why he's not taking the faceoff. But maybe if we're going to be overly critical in overtime in your own zone, you've got another sentiment out there, even though right now I couldn't tell you if it was that faceoff was there because of an icing. If it was because of an icing,
right,
then they got to stay out there. If not, though, I might have sent another centerman like Trocheck, or not Trocheck, but Barkov or somebody out there to take the faceoff. But consequently, I mean, the Rangers gave up a goal on a faceoff play, the third goal in the third period, and Florida gave up a faceoff
right.
play in the overtime. So it sort of evens out.
Yeah.
Not really.
Not really when one decided the game. Exactly.